Goldberg is going to open the show because he's been a great supporter of these two women getting all the bureaucratic stuff sorted out with, I don't know, export licenses and general sort of Russian things. So he'll talk all about that now. And David, please, off you go.
It's a great privilege and a great pleasure to introduce these extremely brilliant paintings by Natalia Ermina and Elena Leontieva from Moscow. This exhibition came about, I suppose, by accident and by a moment of madness. This time last year, there was a lovely exhibition opening, which we came to. Natalia and Elena were here. They had come over from London to stay with me for 3 days, and we went painting around Ireland. The results of those pictures are here. And we came over to the opening, and I said to Caroline, I want to introduce you to two really extremely brilliant Russian painters, and maybe you'd like to give them a show. And to be fair to Caroline, she said, let's see the images. And when she saw the images, she said, yes, let's give them a show. So great credit to Caroline for her courage in offering the space and this time for this show. But if I had had my wits about me, and if Natalia had had her wits about her, she'd have said, this is a completely mad idea. And how are we going to do this? How do you get paintings from Moscow to Dublin? With all the bureaucracy in Russia and all the difficulties and all the problems. And believe me, getting this exhibition here was seriously difficult. But we got the exhibition here. It's on the walls for you to look at and to enjoy and to take home with you. But sadly, we lost one of the painters on the way, which I suppose you could say, in the words of Oscar Wilde, was a moment of carelessness. regrettably, Elena was refused a visa by the UK government, and it was necessary for various reasons for them to come first to London and then to Dublin. So Elena is in Moscow, and we are thinking of her, and we are sending her our love. Now, to go back even further, you say, well, how did I ever meet these two ladies? Please do come in. How did I ever meet these two ladies? Well, I met Natalia in Florence, or outside Florence, at a paint-out run by Tuscany plein air in June of 2016. And we were in this wonderful villa in a village called Bagno a Ripoli. And it rained for 5 out of the 7 days, and it rained heavily. And we were there in this actually rather lovely garden, painting from doorways and windows and under canopies and in the washhouse and so forth. And then on the Friday or Thursday, the sun did come out pretty strongly, and Natalia rushed up the very steep hill in the morning, and she started painting, and she painted this wonderful picture of the olive groves and the cypress trees, so typical of Tuscany. So I went up in the afternoon and I said to her, can I paint with you? She said, please do. And we stood together and we both painted the same view. That was the beginning of this friendship. Then over the summer, I think there was some minimal contact. And in August, she said to me that she was going to be in London for 3 weeks. So I said, well, if you're in London, why don't you come over here? To cut a long story short, she came over and she said, can I bring my friend Elena? And I said, of course. So Elena and Natalia came only for 3 days on that visit. But it was a wonderful occasion because the sun shone and we raced around Dublin. We went to the mountains, we went to Dorking, we went to Loch Shinny. And as I say, there are some examples of those paintings in the other room, which are really wonderful. There is something I must say to you. They're both graduates of the Academy of Fine Art, Painting and Sculpture in Moscow. Graduated about 3-4 years ago. They're both incredibly young girls. In the words of Yeats, there are two lovely women at the window, one a young gazelle. but when you look at these paintings, you think for painters who are so young, they exhibit such incredible skill and talent and ability and artistry in every possible way that is necessary for a painter to work. And at their age, to paint like that is some achievement. I mean, I think other painters would spend an entire lifetime trying to reach that level of standard and that level of ability, and may never achieve it. This is painting of the highest quality. I can't recommend it strongly enough or highly enough to you. And the other thing to be said about it is they are priced at a ridiculously reasonable level. One reason for that is we cannot send these back to Moscow. It's not possible. There's too much bureaucracy involved, so you'll have to take them home. That's why you're here. I want you to give these two lovely girls a Hansel to take home with them, to give them support. Danny Kaye, do you remember Danny Kaye?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he wrote a wonderful song, his wife wrote a wonderful song called Tchaikovsky and the Russian Composers, which he names about 40 composers in this 50-second song. It's wonderful. You could do exactly the same with the Russian painters. They don't seem to come west, well, for reasons of bureaucracy perhaps, and taxation and problems. But there are so many amazingly good painters in Russia. We don't know half of them. We don't know a quarter of them. But if I name people like Repin and Serov and Kuznetsky and others, Dugajapov, then you're talking about really great, great painters. They're the equal of any painter in the West. We know that they're training in the Repin Academy in St. Petersburg and in the Moscow Academy is of the highest possible order. And I'm glad to welcome here this evening another graduate from the Repin Academy who lives and works in Dublin and is Irish and who had a wonderful show here in June, which was incredibly successful, Breed Higgins Nikoneda. So there is something about Russia. When they do art, it's amazing. When you think about Russian musicians, Russian writers, Russian poets, we know about the Tolstoys and Dostoevskys and Chekhovs. We know about Akhmatova. We know about Asaf Mandelstam and so forth. We know about the composers, Ryabin and Shostakovich, Rimsky-Korsakov, Tchaikovsky and Rachmaninoff and Prokofiev and blah, blah. I'm getting like Danny Kaye. And what we don't know is about the artists, but they're all so incredibly good. Every one of them is so incredibly good. But they have continued in a very steady line of painting on a plateau which is gradually increasing slowly and incrementally. There are no isms in Russian painting. They're concerned with construction of a picture, with the technique. It starts with the design and the composition. And look at the design and composition of all of these paintings, but they are exquisitely done. They're so beautifully designed and structured. And after the design and the composition, then you look at the values, the contrast. And in all of these, wonderful contrasts. And you look at the temperature of the paintings, the temperature of the tones. You've got warm and cool, warm and cool. And it takes your eye right around the picture, and it really invites you in, and it seduces you. Well, it should seduce you. If you're not seduced by these paintings, then I don't know what to say to you. You'll never be seduced at all. But these are stunningly good paintings. I recommend them to all of you. And to Elena and to Natalia, I want to say in Russian, Vashe zdorovye! Natalia wants to address you in three languages.
Всем здравствуйте. Спасибо, что пришли. Thank you all for coming. It's a really pleasure to see you all here. And David said everything and 100 times better than I ever could say about our exhibition, about our friendship. And I just want to say our thanks, because I will talk on behalf of my friend Elena as well. I want to thank you for Caroline, who really so easily agreed with such a crazy project. You don't know how much. Yeah. And I want to express my gratitude to David Goldberg, who support us in every possible way, and who believed in us, I think, much more than we did. And this exhibition would never happen without his help and his support. So thank you very much, David, for everything you did for us and for this exhibition. Also, I want to say that David is a wonderful artist, and I learned so much from him. He's too modest he's too modest, but it is true. I learned a lot about painting from him, and for me it was a great experience to be able to paint together, and it's great. So I welcome you all in this show, and I hope you will enjoy it. Thank you for coming.